Today I wanted to do something a bit different, so I've decided to do a video tutorial for you. And what I'm going to do or make is I am going to add polka dots to this vintage denim shirt that I have. I will show you what you need. So you need a shirt. You can pretty much use any fabric that you like. I just wanted to use this denim shirt because I just think it's a bit boring as it is. You need some kind of like marker pen that will show up because you're going to mark your dots with a marker pen before you dot them on with the paint. You need something to actually print your polka dots on with. So it depends on what kind of size you want. You could use like the lid of a Pritt stick or like a wine cork, or I'm going to do quite small ones, so I'm going to use the end of this pen. You need some paint. You could use fabric paint or normal paint. I'm going to use normal paint, and I have these two like test pots, which are in white. And I've just got some tissue because I'll probably make a mess. So, I'll show you what to do. So first of all, you want to spread your denim out as flat as possible. You could, if you wanted, you could use this technique to do like skinny jeans or even leggings or pretty much anything really. You're probably better off using fabric paint, but I don't have any, so I'm just going to go with normal paint. And I've spilt this paint on me before, and I know for a fact that it doesn't wash off fabric, so that's why I'm going to use it. So, first of all, you want to get your marker pen. You could use like chalk or anything really, it doesn't really matter, as long as it's going to show up. And you're just going to go across where you want to do your polka dot, and you're just going to mark where you're going to spot. It might help if you, if you feel a bit unsure, if you like have like another polka dot fabric or like a pattern from the internet or something, so you can just kind of get the general feel of like the spacing. To your palette, and then using I'm going to use this pen, so whatever you decide to use, depending on how big you want your polka dots, we're just going to dab the end into the paint, and you want to make sure that you've got as even a covering on the end as possible. It doesn't matter if all your dots aren't exactly the same, that's kind of the effect that you want to go for. The most important part is the spacing, so it's crucial to mark your dots before you spot, really. And then you're just going to start dabbing your paint on top of where you put your polka dots. So you kind of want something which finishes off looking like this.